organization Consul, a secret organization. It was mostly ex-Freikorps guys, the guys who fought against communism in 1919, veterans, who organized this secret society to keep down the left and to assassinate prominent leftist politicians and anti-nationalist politicians and media people. And it targeted, as most terrorist organizations do, it targeted important people. It did not blow up pizzerias. It didn't blow up sausage, weisswurst, and cabbage bars in Bavaria or Munich coffee houses. And I mean this purely as intellectual historical oddity, you know, that terrorists in our age, generally, they murder nobodies. They regular people they murder. Never anyone important. It's rather odd, don't you think? They never target important people. And in fact, when important people do die in terror attacks, excuse if I repeat myself, there is always something slightly off about them. So if you look at who died in 9/11 terror attacks, even in the tower, it was not just your usual establishment Soros type. And somehow such people are never targeted by terrorists, important people. They never die in terrorist attacks now. And yes, I'm aware of the argument that important people today have much better protection than prominent people did in the 1920s or before, but I am in fact not so sure. And it's not even that there are attempts on them that fail, they're just never targeted by supposed modern terrorists. You would think people, for example, like Bin Laden, who is the sophistication and logistics to pull off something like a 9/11, that he would be able to plan a hit on some rather important people. Because yes, of course, protection capabilities can increase, but so can the sophistication and lethality of adversaries and terrorists. But no, for mysterious reasons, it appears modern terrorists have a hard-on only for killing, discotheque teenagers and people in train stations going to work, but they never target anyone important, only plebeians. It's all rather strange, as I keep telling you.